Well, they did it. The Clippers finally did it by trading Blake Griffin. They are officially entered into the transition stage of team building. So it's any day now DeAndre Jordan is to follow him out the door. Maybe to Cleveland? While it marks the end of an era in Los Angeles, this move puts the Pistons in an interesting spot. For one, they're probably the first team I can remember whose two best passers are the big man. But after a hot start to the year where they were looking kind of nice, they've taken a tumble down the East standings. And let's just say Stan Van Gundy was starting to feel the heat. And nothing is worse than a guy who knows he's as close to getting fired and he has the power to make moves to save his job. And that's what you could sort of call this in a way. Blake Griffin is a star, don't get me wrong, there's no doubt about that. Something they haven't had since Grant Hill, Jerry Stackhouse, at least offensively. And they're not going to get stars to come there in free agency, so trades and drafting are the only route. And I mean, this is the team that passed on Donovan Mitchell for Luke Kennard, so they're proving their skills in that department. So you can see why they jumped at the chance. But this isn't jump over Chevys in a dunk contest, putting a different player on the post every week, Blake. This is 100 injuries later and a monster contract attached, Blake, who likes to punch little people. So the risk is huge of this completely blowing up in the Pistons' face. There's a very real chance of them having a 32-year-old Blake Griffin out for the year being owed $39 million. He could go for my fellow baseball fan CeCe Sabathia with the Brewers on us when he put the team on his back, and he averages 30-10 and they make the playoffs. But what's more likely is there being a push on just how much this affects the Pistons, at least this year. Harris could get buckets now, and Avery Bradley, while not the player he was, is still a decent defender. And Boban lowered opponents' field goal percentages just by looking at him. Make no mistake, Detroit gave up some pieces, but stars they are not, so Detroit had to do it. But the worst thing is they have very limited resources to upgrade their team now. They pushed the chips all in. And now need Stanley Johnson and Luke Kennard to step up. Their core money-wise is Drummond, Blake Griffin, and Reggie Jackson. Yay. And who's going to trade for Reggie Jackson who has 2 years left on his contract? They must pray he doesn't steal too many shots from Blake and Drummond because a facilitator, he is not. If things go south, the only life jacket is trading Drummond to recoup as many picks or young assets as they can. But the expectations are so low for Pistons fans, I feel going 42-40 and losing in 5 to the Celtics or Raptors will count as a successful season to save Van Gundy's job. But I do wonder how their spacing is going to go. They're going to want the ball in Blake's hands, but Drummond can't shoot. But well, I guess he's used to that playing with DeAndre. But I guess this gives him more play off the ball because of Drummond's passing ability. They're not the best fit, but it'll be interesting. But what do you guys think? Did the Pistons trade for Blake move the needle much in Detroit? And how do you feel about the Clippers doing Blake dirty by trading him the very next year after they got him to sign? Leave it in the comments down below. And make sure to subscribe here at Sports Gamers Online so you don't miss any video we put out. I'm Chris. Thank you all for watching, and be good, y'all.